You're listening to America Overnight, mystifying the airwaves for more than 21 years.
fly now. Great.
Feeling he'll be back. Let's stay focused. The hotline should be past the mailroom. Alberto Tomasi, head of comms. The hiss got him.
All right, take this down. The situation in Cuba has been evaluated by the relevant authorities. The mysterious illness affecting the staff at the U.S. Embassy in Havana was caused by sonic weaponry in the hands of a foreign power. Numerous personnel have damage to the inner ear, but most are expected to make a full recovery. Of course, the event also damaged their cellular walls, but we can't blame that on some stupid noise gun. Thank God no local doctors examined them first. Honestly, with the odds of an alternate atom to show up inside a U.S. embassy, talk about good luck, huh? So much easier to... Hey, are you still recording this?
The hotline can't be far now.
Thank you.
been here before? No. I've stayed at a lot of roadside motels across the country, on the road, on the run, under the radar. This feels like all of them, like something recognized from a dream.
Hello? Anyone here? The key has a black pyramid on it.
It is a phone. It's an object of power. It doesn't connect to any typical network. A direct line to the astral plane and the board. And my hypothesis is, under the right conditions, to other planes of existence as well.
A director needs a team. My management team. These people know the secrets of the Bureau as well as I do. Some even better. Darling, Tomasi, Salvador, Marshall. Marshall especially, my head of operations. She sees right through me. She knows I don't like relying on people. The only person you should fail is yourself. But things change when you become director.
Have it. The hotline. I can reach Trench. Well, listen to him. He feels more like an echo. An echo with important info. I need to get back to Emily.
Hotline ringing in my dreams, constantly ringing. Ringing so loud I can't hear the voice I'm straining to understand. Why don't I pick up? It's a secure line of communication with the board. They would tell me what I need to know. Do I fear their answers? Would they have warned me of this threat? I didn't see it coming. The traitor in our midst. A conspiracy plotted right behind me. I can't trust anyone. I must assume all my intel has been manipulated. The hotline is the only channel I can trust. Bind it. Control it. The rule and the ritual with objects of power. It can't be tampered with. The lifeline to the astral plane and the board. I must seek guidance. Soon. I'll rest first. I'm so tired. I'm always tired now. But I must reach the hotline. I think I'm under attack. An attack of dementia, exhaustion. It's a brain cloud making me forget. The hotline. I must reach the hotline. It took us a long time to learn how to stabilize the control points, the ley lines, the meridians of the oldest house. Darling found a way to soothe this beast. We discovered we must cleanse control points of all interference. It's my duty as the director, like Northmore before me. I couldn't manage it in my own house, at my home. I'll damn well do it here. Without the control points, the oldest house would swallow us alive. We'd be sealed inside an endless labyrinth, and no one would hear our screams. If an enemy ever managed to corrupt the control points, it'd be over fast, spreading like a cancer, leaping over the firebreaks like a crown of fire. They are the weak point. Darling's right about that. He's wrong about everything else. Dangerously wrong. Suspiciously wrong. Has he been compromised? A director needs a team. The Ocean View Motel and Casino is a familiar friend to me. I stayed in countless motels like it while investigating AWEs across the country, back in my field agent days. Those roadside motels all bleed together like a dream. Same and not the same. Anywhere and nowhere. The Ocean View operates on dream logic, and the light switch cord leaks out to be found in the most unexpected places, and sometimes successfully encouraged to appear and act as a convenient lock to keep out those not trained in dreamscape navigation. Even Bureau veterans can only find one key in the motel, the key that opens the door marked with the inverted black pyramid. The rest, the many other doors, are still mysteries to us. We're all merely guests there. Even the board. Sometimes I need to visit, just to breathe easier for a while. It beats the numb, sterile apartment I spend my nights in, insulated from everything but myself. I guess that's where the whiskey comes in. Something's coming. The whisper's growing louder. The worst winter storm in Bureau history. Retribution for my sins. Our sins. This threat could destroy the Bureau. Everything I've built. Destroy me. A web spun, turning this place against me. I catch glimpses of it in the corner of my eye. It's just out of reach. Elusive. It's clever. A perverse game of hide and seek. Is this part of an attack? Obfuscating the facts. Dimming my eyes. It's hard to tell. I need answers. I haven't heard back from Darling. I fear for my friend, my closest ally. I think we made a terrible mistake all those years ago. That thing he studies is putting us all in danger. It's my duty as director to keep the Bureau safe. It'll be difficult. What's done can't be undone. There's no easy fix. Magical thinking is a requirement for survival. Pain and suffering are mandatory. To change things, you have to break yourself. I don't know if I have the strength. I'm old and weak. I'm afraid. I can see my hands trembling. I'm losing control.
All right, take this down.
People react strongly when I tell them about you. Is it too soon to tell Emily? She might be able to help.
Jesse, did you get the hotline? I mean, how is it out there? The comms? The hiss? Sorry. You made it. I'm glad.
Emily? Let's talk.
Of course.
I got the hotline. I can make out what Trench is saying now.
Incredible. What did he say?
He talked about his management team. People who knew the Bureau's secrets. Your boss, Darling. Tomasi, but he's gone. He's gone. Salvador?
He's the head of security.
And Marshall?
Helen Marshall is head of operations. She's tough, ex-CIA. She took her Rangers and went to the research sector to secure the HRA production. She hasn't come back.
Someone who could help us. The other sectors. How do I get there?
It's impossible because of the internal lockdown. You can perform a directorial override to lift it, but that can only be done in the maintenance sector. Normally, you take the sector elevator down there. It connects all the sectors, but it won't work while the lockdown is in effect.
We already got past one lockdown.
Maybe I can find a way.
Jesse, look, with no prep, no training, in this extreme situation, you are doing phenomenally well. And all that and the hiss can't seem to affect you. I mean, I would love to run some tests on you. If you agree, that is. We could find out something that would help us.
Tests? I don't know. She might find out about you. But I wouldn't mind understanding more myself.
Okay. If you think it will help.
Great. I'll check the internal documentation for any lockdown bypasses. We need to get these sectors open to locate Darling and Marshall.
And I'll look for a way inside the maintenance sector. The sooner we find one, the sooner I reach this override.
Hi, Jesse.
Thanks, Emily. I'm sure I'll have more questions soon.
Just let me know. Bring me back anything good? Thanks, Emily. I'm sure I'll have more questions soon. Just let me know. Do you hear that? Someone's singing. Where's it coming from?
Singing? Sounds like it's coming from the elevator.
Hope has asked us to document the history.
In person,
with a pencil and paper. I think she's trying to get us killed.
Trench was furious. You don't think, darling...
Don't be stupid. What would the Bureau's golden child have to gain from killing the boss?
Hope wants us to get a field lab set up as soon as possible.
With what? We can't get any equipment from the research sector until the internal lockdown is lifted.
to Smith? Why did they start acting?
Or Trench. How come no one's taking charge here?
You didn't hear? Trench is down.
Time to work. Meet me in Domain de Nanas.
Like I said before, the janitor is a friendly face. The maintenance sector is the janitor domain. If I can find Ati here, he can help me reach the override. Maybe it was you who got me into the oldest house with the lockdown on. Maybe it was Ati. It felt like he made the elevator appear that took me to Trench's office. Is Ati guiding me too? Directorial override is right there, in the control room. How do we get there? Thank you. What's down that way?
Well done. You got the job. It's place for congratulations. Yippee, Satana. It happened in the last drop. I truly need an assistant.
Funny thing is, I've been a janitor. I'm more at home in that role than as the director. Only Ati here seems to see that.
Yeah, hi, Ati. Look, we need to get the lockdown lifted, otherwise I can't get to the other sectors. Can you help me get to the override?
Yes, yes. Easy peasy. It's just around the corner. But first, we need to get you working. Very small couple of hours job.
Something tells me it's gonna be more than that.
You think there's a dog buried in this? I can tell you are not yesterday's Krause's son. That's why you'll make a great assistant. Very well. I'll hit the facts on the table. I'm gonna sanoa perkele suoraan, that this house has a vermin problem. A bad one. They've already messed up the cooling pumps. And the power generators of a power plant, perkele. And the pensioner inside is starting to feel the band around his head tighten. The situation needs to be fixed before the plant blows up. And we all disappear like a fart in Sahara.
Trying my best to keep up with this. Fix the coolant pumps and the power generators, otherwise the power plant will blow.
But don't you worry. I've left you clear instructions. You'll catch the end of the thread before I go to my vacation. The works on the task board here, you can do later, when you have time.
Vacation? Right.
Yes, no one's gonna cancel my holiday or seat's gonna rattle. But don't worry at all, you'll take care of it and soon this crisis gonna be last winter snow. You better go now, so you don't have to run with your head as your third leg. The door in the back leads to the plant.
The door in the back. That's great. Thank you, Ati.
Yep. Burn the dress. Throw it in the fire. Burn it all. Burn it into a reindeer, not into a moose. Oh, it's time for a coffee break.
Okay, so what happens again if that thing blows up?
Power will explode.
Benjamin. Yes. North Pole. Is the director.
Are you new? Go talk with Chief Arish in the security booth. He's in charge here.
Ma'am! Hey! Chief Arish, FBC Security. Shouldn't you be in a safe room?
They all have HRAs. We're on the same side.
My name is Jesse Faden. I'm here to perform the directorial override to get the lockdown lifted.
Yeah. Chief Arish, FBC Security. I'm just... Oh, hang on. You're the new director. It's a pleasure, ma'am.
Let's skip the formalities, please.
Right. Faden, ma'am. Look, as you can probably tell, it's a bit of a shit show down here. We've been holding our ground, but whatever's gotten into our buddies has them wrecking the coolant pumps and the power converters. The NSC keeps overheating, and my crews keep getting shot before they have a chance to make any repairs.
NSC?
Oh, sorry. Bureau jargon. It's what we call the power plant. You know, the big rumbling metal thing? Salvador, head of security, asked me to protect it in case of an attack. See, what's inside is dangerous. Dr. Darling seemed to know it would be a target.
Darling? He's here?
No, he came down a few days ago, before everything went to hell. He was out of it. Smelled like a bar mat. He was ranting about vulnerabilities and how he only had one large-scale HRA, but that he needed it somewhere else. Still, at least he gave us these personal HRAs before he left. Hey, did I mention that he was tearing his clothes off? Crazy dude.
Darling knew the hiss was coming.
Listen, I love playing 20 questions as much as the next guy, but we have got to get the water and electrical systems repaired before this baby blows. I'll have my guys unlock the doors out of here for you.
I'll take care of it. You stay and keep the hiss away from the plant if you can.
The hiss? That's what we're calling him? Well, that's catchy. Oh, listen, the radios aren't working, so if you find my boss Salvador out there, could you please ask him what the plan is? I'm sure he will have one by now.
I'll keep an eye out for him.
He sure has a lot of faith in his boss.
Try to stay alive.
Need those pumps and converters online?
She knows. She knows.
I just wanted to make sure.
Energy conversion's well below the acceptable percentage. Internal pressure's climbing so fast, I'm amazed the NSC is still holding. When it blows, we're all going with it.
Oh, thanks, Frank.
If we give up, the building gives up. Bureau needs us to keep it together down here.
Oh God, if that thing blows.
If we give up, the building gives up.
Here comes the director. This is the longest day of my life.
When the converters and coolant pumps are working again, we should be able to get this baby back down to a safe temperature. I hope.
What do you know about the Hiss?
Not much, only what I've seen. Well, they use the same tactics that Marshall and Salvador taught us, which makes me think that the Hiss haven't completely erased the people inside, which is a pretty fucking horrible thought. Or they're just using whatever they find in their victims' heads. In any case, they are really eager to get inside the power plant.
Why do you think that is?
Shit, I don't know. They want to make my life harder?
What do you know about the Hiss?
Not much, only what I've seen. Well, they use the same tactics that Marshall and Salvador taught us, which makes me think that the Hiss haven't completely erased the people inside, which is a pretty fucking horrible thought. Or they're just using whatever they find in their victims' heads. In any case, they are really eager to get inside the power plant.
Why do you think that is?
Shit, I don't know. They want to make my life harder?
What do you do here, Arish?
Security chief of the maintenance sector. I make sure all the weird shit down here doesn't bother the maintenance crews. Learned everything I know from Salvador, the best security agent this bureau has ever seen.
And you like your job?
I love it. You know, everyone thinks that maintenance is the lowest rung on the ladder just because we fix pipes instead of writing memos, but I gotta be honest, these are the bravest people in the goddamn building. I'm proud to work with them.
I've done a few odd jobs with these kind of folks. They say what they mean. I like that. What exactly is the power plant?
Listen, I only know what Salvador told me, but I know it generates all the electricity for the Bureau, and it's got two very simple rules. Rule one, keep it below a certain temperature. Rule two, don't ever, ever open it. Oh, and three, it's classified, so I shouldn't ask.
Sounds like secrets are standard operating procedure around here.
Oh, yeah. It's all part of the job.
What do you know about the service weapon?
Not much. That thing is director only. Salvador told me by the time he saw Trench use it. Sounds like that gun can do some serious damage. Yeah, I did see pictures of it once, though, and it looks different to that thing you're carrying. You monitor something? It's new.
Is new a good thing?
Given the circumstances, I'd say new is our best bet.
I should be going.
Right. You got a lockdown to lift.
Crew feels a lot safer when you're around.
Do you know this Ati guy?
Of course. He's my favorite coffee break buddy. Dude has got some crazy stories. He probably knows more than anyone else around here. If you can make sense of what he's saying.
Any idea where he's from?
I'm guessing Sweden.
He's from where he's from. Look, there are just some stones that are better left unturned, you know?
I should be going.
Right. You got a lockdown to lift.
itching for some real action.
Replace the parts. Thank you.
like that sound.